Hi, I'm Chloe. Thank you for visiting our video. Find out why our team can provide you the best services for your needs. Hundreds of clients can't be wrong. Check out the following video.
Real estate with realtor Kashif Sohail. Welcome to Washington America show with international multimedia journalist, multidimensional, multifaceted artist and director of Human Rights Justice Council USA, Dr. Kashif Sohail.
It's very useful for home buyers, sellers, investors and learners to know about real estate contracts. A contract is a legally enforceable agreement between competent parties who agree to perform, or refrain from performing, certain acts or omissions. A legally enforceable contract represents the exact meeting of the minds, the agreement, of the parties involved. Real estate is a business of contracts, listing contracts, sales contracts, option contracts, leasing contracts, development contracts, installment sales contracts, and financing contracts to name a few. Offers may be terminated in several ways, including counteroffer, revocation, and death or insanity. Often, the offer to purchase is not the only offer exchanged between buyer and seller. The buyer, offerer one who makes an offer, initially makes an offer to purchase to the seller, offeree one who receives the offer. If the seller rejects the initial offer, and then makes a counteroffer, the roles are reversed. The seller then becomes the offerer and the buyer the offeree with respect to the seller's counteroffer.
By making a counteroffer, the initial offer is terminated and replaced by a new offer. Multiple counteroffers may occur, with the roles of offerer and offeree switching between buyer and seller. An offerer may withdraw his offer at any time before the offeree accepts it. However, there is no sale contract until or unless one offers may be terminated in several ways. An offerer, the one making the offer, may withdraw his offer at any time prior to its acceptance by the offeree, the one receiving the offer, unless, for example, the offer is contained in a valid option contract. If the offerer withdraws the offeree no longer has the power to accept it and there can be no contract from the rejected offer. Lapse of time, some offers terminate automatically if they are not accepted by a deadline established by the parties. Specifying a deadline for acceptance is one way to control an offer after it is communicated. The death or insanity of either party prior to acceptance will terminate an offer. For a contract to be legally binding, an offer and an acceptance must be supported by consideration. Consideration is a legal term that has a long history of interpretation and discourse in contract law. However, today consideration is understood to broadly exist where parties bargain with one another to exchange promises. Through this bargaining process, the parties agree, or promise, to do or not to do something like deliver title in exchange for payment. The thing that both parties agree to do or not to do is the essence of consideration. Without consideration, there is merely a one-sided promise to act out of charity, and courts are reluctant to bind someone to perform a charitable act, even if they so promise. As a result, If a person promises to give away property without any consideration, give promise, but later changes his mind, the one-sided promise would be unenforceable.
In a real estate transaction, the buyer makes an offer to buy property that the seller accepts. Dissecting this exchange of promises, we find consideration. The seller promises to do something, deliver the deed to the property at a specified time to the buyer, and the buyer promises to do something, pay a specified sum of money for that deed.
If a seller promised to merely give his property to another as a gift, the seller's one-sided promise would lack consideration and could be unenforceable. This is true because there was no bargain for exchange of promises between the two parties, or no consideration, only the seller is promising to do something. We do not intend to communicate that one cannot give their property away, they can. However, if one promises to give it away, but changes her mind, the promise could be unenforceable.
Even where there is an offer and acceptance that is supported by consideration, there may not be a valid or enforceable contract. Certain defenses may exist that prevent a contract from being formed in the first place. Other defenses permit a party to escape liability from the contract, even though the contract is valid. In either case, these two types of defenses result in either a contract being void, a theory that the contract was never properly formed, or voidable, a theory that a contract is valid, but fairness dictates that one may get out of the contract if he proves the defense. The important distinction between contracts that are void and contracts that are voidable is as follows. Void contracts are never binding, and voidable contracts are binding unless or until a party successfully asserts a relevant defense. Common defenses which render a contract void or voidable include incompetency, misrepresentation, mistake, illegality, and duress. Generally, courts assume people are competent to enter into contracts with one another. However, some people are legally unable to contract because they lack capacity. As a result, their contracts are void. People that entirely lack capacity to contract include those that are legally insane. Others have only a limited capacity to enter into contracts. These contracts are voidable, which means that one must take steps to avoid responsibility for the contract. Both minors and intoxicated persons are examples of those with a limited capacity to contract. Those who are adjudicated incompetent or insane by a court have no capacity to contract, and may never be a party to a legally binding contract. This is logical because legally incompetent individuals cannot be expected to understand the terms of a contract. Therefore, a legally incompetent person cannot agree because an agreement requires understanding.
If a legally incompetent person is judged to have been lucid or temporarily of sound mind at the time he entered into the contract, then the contract remains valid, even where the person returns to insanity after signing the contract. Finally, a person who is actually insane, but has not been declared insane by a court possesses a limited capacity to contract. His contracts are therefore voidable and not void. Minors, those under 18 years of age in most states, have a limited capacity to contract. Therefore, their contracts are generally voidable. This means that a minor may enter into a contract, but he may escape liability for the contract if he subsequently rejects it. For example, if a minor enters into a contract to buy a car, the minor will not be obligated under the contract to buy the car because he is not competent to contract.
The contract is voidable on behalf of the minor. However, if the minor wants to buy the car, the seller is bound by the terms of the contract and must sell. However, contracts with minors for necessities such as food or clothing are neither void nor voidable, and the minor will be held to such contracts. Persons who are intoxicated at the time of the contract also have a limited capacity to contract. Such contracts may be voidable by the intoxicated person if they act promptly. If they do not act promptly to cancel the contract, their inaction will be taken as agreement, and the contract will be valid. If there is any dispute regarding one's competency, it must be settled in court. Fraud is any form of deceit by which one party intentionally attempts to gain an unfair advantage over another. The key to determining whether an action is fraudulent is whether or not it was intentional. If the deceit was not intentional, it is not fraud, but may be an instance of misrepresentation. Fraud includes intentionally making false statements and/or intentionally concealing material facts about a property. Fraud may result in damage awards by a court, and either a void or voidable contract depending upon the circumstances. If a party to a contract is induced to sign the contract because of fraudulent statements or facts, then the contract is voidable by the injured party. For example, Sam Jones, who runs his business out of his home, signs a contract to buy a particular house because the seller pledges that local ordinances will allow his home business. Later Sam finds that this is not true, and that the seller knew it was not true. The seller is guilty of fraud and the contract is voidable by Sam.
So, since you've learned more about us, click the link in the description to see how you can contact us.
Please share this video, subscribe to our channel.
Are you looking to buy or sell a home anytime soon? If so, you've come to the right place. We'd like to give you the opportunity to work with one of the top local real estate agents and get the best deal when buying or selling a home. The fact is, experienced agents can often get you a 2 to 10% better deal on the purchase or sale of a property, mostly due to their experience in the local marketplace and their ability to negotiate the best deal. So contact our top agent now and start the process of buying or selling your home.